think. I just think he's a hero. Georgie the Belfast boy. Please welcome George Best. Georgie, the Belfast boy.
It was good, that guy, wasn't he?
Which one?
Playing the football.
I was going to ask you about him. How long do those pictures seem ago?
Oh, a long time ago. I mean, I used to have hair and a black beard. Now it's, I don't know, it was great. That time was special, the 60s and 70s.
But when you see, can you remember each of those moments when we show them on VT like that, and other shows always show you goals? Can you remember the specific goals?
I can, yeah. That's the nice thing about it, the fact that you know, I'm still working 25 years after that. And kids, fortunately, have the chance to buy videos and tapes, and their dads, and in my circumstances, mostly great-granddads show them the videos. It's lovely that they, you know, when I do book signings or I go and speak at theatres, it's lovely to see the front two, three rows packed with kids who've never seen me play live. So it's a hell of a compliment.
I never saw you play. It's one of my biggest regrets. I don't know what everybody else feels. I'd love to see George Best play live. So the moment when you had those two sort of defenders on your back there and you just stopped, did you see that clip?
Yeah.
There? You just stopped, you know, God, what should I do? And you just had, and they were so petrified, those defenders.
Yeah, but it was only Bobby Moore, I mean.
Is that who it was? I didn't notice that. Was that him?
It was against West Ham, yeah.
And he was backing off.
Yeah, I mean, it's changed now. I wish I was playing today, you're not going to tackle anybody, are you?
Not from behind, anyway.
Can you imagine some of the players when I played, Nobby Styles and Chopper Harris,
leg breakers,
Tommy Smith. I mean, they wouldn't have finished the game, would they?
But I was talking to Gazza once about, you know, how he plays football, and he said, well, you know, you can't really explain. He doesn't like talking about it, funnily enough. He just can't bother talking about it. He says, well, the thing is, I sort of know three moves ahead what's going to happen. I said, well, how do you know? He said, I don't know, I just know. I mean, what was it like for you?
I think you find that with great players. You have to think ahead. That's a sign of a great player. I remember listening to Beckenbauer once as well, and he said if they stopped the game at any particular time, he could tell you where every one of his teammates were if he stopped the game.
But how do you know that, though? Is that a sixth sense?
It's something you're born with.
You can't see. I mean, you literally can't see out the back of your head, but you just know they're there.
Great players have that vision as well. That's why, also, I think you find great players over the years really don't, very rarely get hurt. Pele didn't have many injuries. Maradona didn't.
Lineker?
You know, Cruyff didn't really. Gary Lineker, I mean. And poor old Gazza is the exception, of course. I mean, he's had some terrible injuries.
Well, he reckons that one of the reasons he gets injured a lot is because he has the ball at his feet, because he plays in a holding role.
Yeah.
So the ball's at his feet a lot, so he gets chopped a lot.
The other thing about Gazza is maybe he's too brave. I mean, you know, he goes in where other people don't want to go, because he's such a competitor, he wants to win all the time. And I think sometimes that hurts him a little bit.
If you could play in any present World Cup team in this World Cup, if you could join them, which I'm sure they'd welcome immensely, which team would you want to play with?
Well, I'd love the Brazilians. I always have done. And I mean, I never played in the World Cup finals. And you know, playing for Northern Ireland, we really didn't get too many chances to appear in the World Cup finals. It would have been nice to have gone there. But if I had to pick a side to play pure, total football, it's Brazil. I mean, they've started off with 3 points and didn't play particularly well, but they're the sort of side, they step up a gear, and I think we'll see that through.
Well, when Scotland equalised, they did just... It was like well done, Scotland, by the way. And you were very unlucky, and we're behind you. I mean, look, we've got one Scottish flag up there. There you go. That's the one Scottish flag. It was like the Harlem Globetrotters. They just went somewhere else, didn't they?
They do, yeah. No, they just have an extra gear. That's what it is. And when you've got players, I mean, they brought in a lad sitting on the bench who is worth 20 million, and he can't get in the team. I mean, so what chance the rest of us got? And this Ronaldo was a little bit special as well. He had a reasonably quiet game, but they just seem to get better and better.
Now, the money that's made in the game today for even an average professional is immense. Mm. But you were a big earner in your day. I mean, and in between all the games, you know, that are on right now at the moment, you often see the footballers, especially Shearer, popping up in more than one advert sometimes.
Yeah.
But this isn't a new thing. You were in lots of TV adverts, weren't you?
Well, years ago, I mean, I advertised everything. I did chewing gum. I did an ad for the Egg Marketing Board, sausages, aftershave, which I don't do anymore.
Well, we've got it. I was going to say, because we've got the aftershave ad. Do you mind if we play the aftershave?
No, no.
This is like the coolest advert you've ever seen. George Best advertising aftershave. It's called Four.
real Damascus. Aftershave, hairspray, talc, the lot. Four brings out the best in a man.
Way before your Nikes and your Reeboks and your Adidas.
That must have been an Irish company did that, calling it four.
I mean, but you didn't actually act in that. You didn't take a speaking role. You didn't have to learn any lines.
No,
you?
I'll tell you something, Chris, about that. They were supposed to start shooting in Hyde Park, they did it, at 8 o'clock in the morning. And as you probably know, I'm not very good at getting up at 8 o'clock. Getting in at 8 o'clock, maybe, but not getting up at 8 o'clock. And I went down to see my good friend Johnny Gold at Tramp. And crawled home at whatever time it was. And they find me, I think, at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So they had to reschedule the whole idea. The original idea was to drive down the King's Road with all the girls and a couple of Afghan hounds in the back. And we ended up shooting that in about 20 minutes.
Just wandering through the park. It still looks great, though. But in the sausage advert, that you did have a speaking role. Do you want to see the sausage advert? I think it's fun. I would love to know how much you got paid for this. This is George Best. Do you eat sausages in those days?
I do, yeah.
Okay, George Best advertising cracking bangers.
It takes something special to get Georgie Best away from football.
What the man means is, he's talking about the best family sausages.
The most delicious sizzles have always come from Cookstown.
What was the going rate for an advert like that in those days?
The going rate was as many sausages and meat pies you could eat for the rest of your life. After that, I mean, you know what it's like when you do commercials. There was not many takes. I don't think I've ever honestly had a sausage since then, because I must have ate 16 pounds of sausages just getting that one line right.
OK, well, we've got to go now, George. I can talk to you all night. And do you know what? I probably will later. I'll probably bore the ears off you. That's the ears off you, by the way. And are you enjoying yourself at the moment? Are you having a good time?
It's brilliant. I mean, they keep telling me how down and out I am. You know, I write for Punch magazine. I've got my own monthly magazine out, which sold 170,000 copies the first month. I've got a new book out, a biography out, and I'm working on a film. A guy called John Lynch, who's just made a film called Sliding Doors, right, which is fabulous, and he's working on a project that's been going on for years. So
you're doing all right.
I do the after dinners, and
he's doing Sky Sports and everything. It's nice to have you here, George. Good to see you looking well. Nice George Best. Come on, George Best, the legend. My thanks to George, the gorgeous Harry Ball, and Brown, and the fantastic Hanson. By the time you see us next, England will have 3 points. 3 points in their qualifying group. But now we must go. Here's Bernard Butler with his brand new song, one of my favourite songs around at the moment. It's called A Change of Heart. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.